Today, friends, we're going to use Tinkercad's fantastic Sketch Revolve to make a fantastic fidget star. So let's get cracking. This is Tinkercad.com. It is a website for 3D design. You can simply choose sign in with Google. Your homepage looks like this. I'm going to bounce down to designs. There are three kinds of designs we can make: 3D designs, circuits, and code blocks. Today we're going to play with 3D designs. They are all stored to the cloud, and initially they're private, but you can make them public. Today we're going to hit create new 3D design. I like to start with naming projects. This one is going to be called Fidget Star. Tinkercad is fantastic for beginners because you can simply bring shapes out and stack them together to make awesome creations. You can see how almost instantly we've got a house. Now, the other thing I want to highlight is once you do that, it immediately saves. If we back out to the Tinkercad dashboard, here is our project saved instantly. To get back in, you simply hit Tinker This. Now, we are not making a house today, so I'm going to delete those two objects. If you are interested in day one lessons, I've got several tutorials. You can, of course, follow this bit.ly or check the cards. Now, today we're going to build with the fantastic Sketch Revolve tool. Notice it is a 20 by 20 shape, so drop it right in the center. That black dotted line helps you line it up. This is the area where we do sketches, but before I do that, I want to click up here on the sketch features. This is updated all the time. You can click through it. There are awesome animations, tons of cool tricks that'll make you better with the sketch tool. Of course, you can exit by clicking right here. You can always find it again if you need it. If you prefer my tutorials, I've got a playlist I'll add right here, or you can also check the video's cards. Sketch lets us use straight lines, curves, smooth curves. Today, though, we're going to stick with just straight lines. Move out 1 centimeter. Click and start a line. Move 1 centimeter up, but then 5 millimeters out. And then we're going to simply do the next piece right here. Hit escape to cancel that line. Double check your measurements. 5 by 20. And take a look at the preview. Right now it's round, but I promise we will fix that in a little bit. We need to make this larger. We're simply going to do Control C. And if you do Control Shift V, it's in the exact same location. Now we can simply nudge that out. This is the minimum gap. I'm going to go past that. 1, 2, 3 clicks. Now what I want you to see right here is that this blue corner cannot go past that edge. That's what makes this trick work. Now, we can make these as far as we want. Once again, you can also make them thinner, but I'm just going to grab this and do Control C and Control Shift V again, and let's do a shift nudge to move it over. You can see that gets close, and then it's 1, 2 clicks, and this dotted blue line is kind of cool because it shows you that it's right here, which means this edge right here will be on the correct side of that. I'm going to stop at 4. If you wanted to make this a little thinner, I'll let you know that you can just grab them all and make it so the gap in the middle is smaller. That's up to you. So now when we hit finish sketch, we have got our shape. It is round, which is a little silly. We're going to simply go to the sides, type 4, and press enter. That is what we want. But we're also going to turn this so that we got a flat edge. If you type 45 right here, bang, it has got the shape we want, which makes this super slick. We're going to quickly switch to top view. We're going to press F to fit view, so you're right over top of it. And we want to put a sketch right there in the center. You can see that it lines up nice and smooth. All right, so now we need to make the awesome parts to make the star. Let's switch to a size 5 nudge. We're going to click right out here, and notice how this is about 25. We're going to go out to 40 and up 40, and then simply connect it. P for pen, do that same thing vertically, 40, 40, and connect. P for pen, 40, straight down 40, and connect. It's starting to look like a pinwheel. P for pen, and do the 40, the 40, and connect. When you hit finish sketch, zoom out, make it so it's taller, set it to be a hole. This is where it gets cool, friends. We are going to rotate it 22 and a half degrees. And when we set it down, it's going to trim these so we got the points of our star. Select them all. Do Control G to union group. Grab that shape and do Control D to make another one. Rotate it 45 degrees. And are you ready for that? You have just built your printable fidget star. How cool is that? All right, so we need to trim off these sharp edges so it's easier to print. We're going to do that with the whole cube. When you bring it out, we need to make sure that it's larger than 64 by 64. So I'm just going to grab this and I'm going to shift stretch that corner. There it's 88. But then I'm going to tell you that the height I'm going to use is 1.2. I'm going to select everything, do L for align, and choose center and center. I want to make another one of these, do Control D. I'm going to do Control up to get it to the top-ish. And then I'm just going to pick these top three pieces. Choose L for align, but this time I'm going to choose one of the green ones and make sure it aligns to the top. You can see how those are going to trim. We can simply just grab it and do Control G to group. Bang! You have got a fantastic star fidget. Let's quickly hit D to drop to get it on the work plane. I'm going to hit export and send it to the 3D printer. The selected shape, STL, in my 3D modeling folder, and I'm going to call it Fidget Star. Now I can bounce to Bambu Lab Studio. We're going to create a brand new project. Let's add that Fidget Star. I'm going to print it with the Army PLA. Let's slice the plate. Notice 37 minutes and print the plate. And not too much later, bam, we have got a sweet fidget star. And here we are with all the fidgets. So this is the one with a single space in between them. Notice it moves really cool, but it does not stick out very far when you turn it. This is the one we just made. Notice it pushes out a long ways. Still super cool for the spinning. Of course, I kept nudging to try the different versions. One click, two clicks, and then finally, these are the three clicks. As I wrap up, friends, obviously Sketch Revolve made that so slick. Also, being able to trim it with the sketch tool was fantastic. I'd love to hear what you think in the comments below. Of course, friends, I do want to say thank you to everybody that supports me via YouTube memberships. Don't forget there are three different levels of support, starting as low as $5 a month. With any level of support, you get early access to videos. Also, a massive shout out to my Patreon supporters. Love how that group is growing. The community is up to almost 300 members. It has a fantastic messaging area where even free users can ask questions, gain skills, and get some support. Of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you like, hype, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day, and keep tinkering.